Welcome back to Magnetized Labs. Today we will explore the process of designing a USB sound card using the PCM2706 in KiCAD. Upon completion, the final PCB layout will resemble this design. I will guide you step by step from the fundamentals, so stay tuned until the end. Understanding the USB sound card. A USB sound card serves as an interface to convert audio signals between analog and digital formats. While some sound cards are integrated into motherboards, others are standalone devices that offer enhanced audio performance. Many individuals assume that sound cards are solely responsible for improving audio quality, but their primary role is signal conversion. High quality components and proper design significantly impact the resulting audio fidelity. Here in the black diagram, I have shown the design operation of the project. In this board, PCM2706 digital to analog converter has been used that has many features. I am going to explain that very soon. And then I have used the DC blocking capacitors to filter out the noise, and then the direct analog output is fed to the audio jack output. On the other hand, I have given a USB type A male connector to directly interface with laptop or CPU or any other multimedia device which is having USB connection. What is PCM2706? The PCM2706 is a USB audio codec from Texas Instruments that integrates both digital to analog and analog to digital conversion. It enables USB connectivity for audio devices without requiring complex driver installations, and it's sampling at 48 kHz at the maximum frequency, and it has 16-bit resolution for both left and right channel. The signal-to-noise ratio is 98 decibels. It also features the human interface device option, such as increasing the volume or decreasing the volume, switching to the next track, switching to the previous track, playing the track, pausing the track, or you can mute down the track. SPDIF output, so Sony Philips digital interface output, which we are not going to use that, but these are all the features available in this PCM2706. We'll come to the schematics now. I'm going to explain step by step so that you will be able to easily understand what is going on in this project. First pin is power ground pin, so I have directly connected it to ground. Second pin is analog supply pin, which is used for oscillator sections, and then external EEP rope if it is connected, and then internal phase locked loop sections. Third pin is host pin. In self power mode, it is used to direct the host, but we are using bus powered mode. In this bus powered mode, this host pin is used to select the maximum power during the application. I have connected it to ground to select 100 milliamps current supply. If you connect it to high, you will get 500 milliamps. Pin number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 18 and 19. These are all the pins are used for a human interface device. Each pin serves a different purpose, such as playing the track, pausing the track, demute the track, switching to the next track, switching to the previous track, increasing the volume of the track, and decreasing the volume of the track. But we are not going to use that, so I have kept it as no connect. This pin is function select pin, which is used to select whether this Dout pin should serve as a SPDIF output or I2S output. I have chosen to go with SPDIF output, although we are not going to use that. 10th pin is a test pin. As per the datasheet recommendation, I have connected this pin to BD. 11th pin is a suspend flag pin. This will denote whether the IC is operational or it is suspended. When it is zero, it is suspended. When it gives high, it is operational. This is the crystal oscillator section. I have used 12 MHz crystal with 12 picofarad load capacitors and 1 MΩ resistor for damping. 14th pin and 15th pin, clock and data. These pins are used to connect to external EEP ROM. We are not going to use that. I have kept as it is. 16th pin is a power select pin. Connecting to the VDD selects bus powered mode, and connecting to the ground selects self power mode. I am using bus powered mode, so I have connected it to VDD. This is the digital ground. I have connected it to ground. This is the internal voltage regulator output. And these are the USB data plus and data minus lines. This is the VBUS, bus powered application. I have connected 5 volt directly to this pin. Z ground, I have connected it to ground. And then analog ground for left channel, I have connected it to ground. This is the analog voltage supply for the left channel operation. I have connected it to a decoupling capacitor. And then V out L and P out R, analog audio outputs, which is going to connect to the 3.5mm audio jack. This is the analog supply for the right channel operation. This is analog ground for the right channel. V count, common mode voltage for the left and right channel operation. Filter capacitors and resistors. This is DC blocking capacitors. This I will explain what it is doing. Pull down resistors for a better signal integrity, and then it is directly connected to the 3.5 mm standard audio jack. Why capacitors at the analog output? It easily blocks the DC offset so that it will not allow the harmonics into the output analog audio. It couples between the input and output stages. It prevents low frequency noise. Here in the USB data lines, I have used 22 ohm series termination resistors so that the total impedance of the circuitry, including the internal part of the IC, will comply to the USB specification. I have pulled up the USB data plus line for the computer or CPU to direct the host. I have used USB type A male connector for easier operation of connecting to the laptop or CPU. We can go for the PCB layout, but before going to the PCB, if you want to use the different connector for this application, you can go ahead for that. You can use a type C connector, female receptacle in this place, and you can connect through a cable, which is also acceptable. In such case, you will be able to place your USB sound card whichever the place you want at your convenience. When it comes to a PCB layout, this is a very simple layout with minimal components. I have kept the USB type A male connector at one end of the PCB so that we will be able to easily connect it to a laptop or a CPU wherever it is. This is a USB differential routing with 90 ohm impedance matched. So this board is a 4-layer board. These are all the 22 ohm series termination resistors and then decoupling capacitors. I have kept as close to the IC as possible, and the B common mode decoupling capacitor, 1 mega ohm damping resistor for the crystal oscillator section. This is a crystal with 12 picofarad load capacitors. This is the DC blocking capacitor. Analog output I have directly connected to a 3.5 mm standard audio jack. When designing the PCB, several best practices should be followed. Keep traces short and minimize interference. If possible, separate analog and digital ground planes to reduce the noise. Place the decoupling capacitors close to the power pins. Use proper shielding techniques to enhance the audio quality. We will go to the 3D part now. So this is USB type A connector, and this is 3.5 mm audio jack for the easy accessible purpose. This is the central PCM2706 digital to analog converter with its decoupling capacitors, and then this is the DC blocking capacitor for the left and right channel crystal oscillator section. I have kept everything on the top of the PCB so that we will be able to easily assemble and test. Benefits of using USB sound card. It is portable and compact. Quick replacement to the broken audio jacks. Sometimes bypasses the existing audio hardware for better sound quality. Built-in amplifier for boosting the big audio signals. Special effects and virtual surround sound for gaming and streaming applications. When it comes to the applications part of USB sound card, it is widely used in gaming, connecting to external speakers, multimedia video and audio editing, plug and play devices, advanced audio processing, and mainly it is used in car audio systems. Designing a USB sound card with the PCM2706 requires careful planning, but the result is a high performance audio interface. With the right approach, you can create a professional grade sound card suitable for various applications. You can try it on your own and you can test it with your CPU or laptop. If you found this guide helpful, stay tuned for more insightful tutorials at Magnetized Labs. We will attach the schematic and the BOM in the description. If you have any doubts or feedback, please let us know in the comment section. We are very happy to help. Thank you for watching.